Outbreeding is in three types. First one is outcrossing, crossbreeding, interspecific hybridization. Outcrossing, so here the mating animals within the same breed, but there is no having common ancestors or pedigree of the four to six generations. See, outcrossing, the mating of animals within same breeders, but there is no having common ancestors and there is no pedigree of the fourth to sixth generations. So there is no common ancestors in between the two individuals, so that but the they are belongs to the same breeders, so that two individuals are involved in the mating process, that is called as outcrossing. Second one is cross breeding. Here you know that one generally desirable characteristics are observed here. Superior males of the one breeder and superior females of another breeder. If we selecting the superior males of one breeder, so and superior females of the another breeder, so that belongs to the same breeders, same species, but here that is breeding with both individuals, that is called as crossbreeder. And here Isardale, that is one of the sheep, is present in the Punjab, so it is crossed with Bikaneriyas merino rams of sheep, so which gives the more woolen. Okay, right. So and the next one is interspecific hybridization, right? Here interspecific hybridization means the mating process or mating of the animals into the different animals or that belongs to the different species. See here, male donkey, one example, male donkey that combines with the female horse. Here both different breeders, it is the donkey but it is the horse. Here male donkey that breed or mating with the female horse, then produce here mule. Okay, and as well as the male horse that is combines to the female donkey, here they produce henny. Okay, mules and hennies are the interspecific hybridization, but they are the similar characteristics like here donkey and horse, but they produce the different types of the organisms like here mule and henny. And next one is one of the another concept is controlled breeding. Right, so controlled breeding within the situations or within the control, or when we prepared the some observations, that is the controlled breeding. Controlled breeding, so how it is possible the controlled breeding? So it is the observation breeding. So here only the two types of methods are there. So first one is artificial insemination. Artificial insemination, and next one is MOET, multiple ovulation embryo transfer. So these are the techniques for using the controlled breeding. See here the artificial insemination. See, what is the meaning of artificial insemination? Means collecting of the semen from the superior males, collecting the semen from the superior males, and that semen is presenting at the female reproductive tract. So that is the artificial insemination. So you are collecting the semen from the superior male, that means superior bulls. Okay, here when we collected that semen, that is introducing into the female reproductive tract. So the by the sexual process, the yeah, super ovulation is processed, then automatically the controlled breeding is appeared. See, these artificial semen or artificial insemination, the semen is when we collected that bull's semen, right? That is transported for the frozen situation. See here, when the suppose the female superior female is housing in different area, but the female male superior male is housing in another area. When we collecting this insemination, artificial insemination, that means when we collecting the semen, that is transported by the processing of the frozen characteristics. So it is completely ice age or freezing conditions. So that is helps to, that is transferred to the where the female housing superior female. So then it reached to the combines to the female and male, female with the male semen. So here the artificial insemination process can be done. Okay, right. Next one is MOET. MOET means multiple ovulation embryos transfer. Multiple ovulation embryo transfer. See, generally the cows are administered by the FSH hormone. So the cows are administered by the FSH hormone. This FSH hormone induces the super ovulation and follicular maturation, right? The cows are administered by the FSH hormones. This FSH hormone that induces the super ovulation and follicular maturation. So when the male or female participated or mating by the elite bull, here the female mating with the elite bulls, right? In the stage of sexually contacted, in the stage of eight to 32 cell stage, the embryo can be transferred to the surrogacy mother. So here the surrogacy mother has the transformer or maintaining the embryo for the end of the stage. Okay, so this is the multiple ovulation embryo transfer. See here, the cows are the administered by the FSH hormone, follicular stimulating hormone. So this follicular stimulating hormone inhibits the super ovulation and follicular maturation. Here the female mating with the elite bulls, so by the sexual contact, so in the period of 18 to 32 cells of embryo or stage, the embryo transferred to the surrogacy mother. The surrogacy mother is maintaining the embryo till the delivery. Okay, so these are the controlled breeding.